This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Greetings to you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Welcome to God's message from Evans Chapel United Methodist Church, all the way in the big city of Belzoni, Mississippi, a church where everybody is somebody and Jesus is Lord. Let's continue to remember that we are still in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, and we want to continue to follow social distancing in public, wear our mask, and if you have not had an opportunity to get vaccinated, please do so. And those who have been vaccinated, at your earliest convenience, earliest opportunity to get your booster shot, I advise you to do that as well. Do want to announce that Bible study will be this Tuesday at 5 o'clock p.m. via teleconference. If you want to join in, feel free to call me and I will give you the teleconference number that we use. And what do I want to remind you that Regional Charge Conference will be October 31st, 2021 at 6:30 p.m. via Zoom. And as soon as I get the Zoom invite, I will pass it on to you guys. We're going to move on with our opening song. If It Had Not Been for the Lord on My Side by Helen Baylor.
There's a song I want to do right now that reminds me of my grandmother, and you've heard me tell my story how she prayed me through. When I got saved, when I got delivered from drugs and alcohol, my grandmother, she told me, she said, "There's a song I want you to learn. And when you come back to my church, I want you to sing it."
If it had not been for the Lord on my side, tell me where would I be?
Amen, amen. If It Had Not Been for the Lord on My Side by Helen Baylor. Amen. Let's go to God in prayer before we move to our message for today. Father God, we want to say thank you. We thank you for being good to us. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. We thank you for another opportunity to come back together one more time to fellowship, even in this virtual space, Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, because whether in person or virtual, it's an opportunity to still fellowship and commune with you as the body of Christ. Lord, we thank you for that. Lord, we thank you for another day, Lord. Lord, because you didn't have to give it to us, Lord, but I'm glad that you did. I'm glad you woke us up this morning. I'm glad you allowed us to witness another day that you have prepared just for us. Lord, we thank you for the good times, the bad times, the sunshine and rain. Lord, we thank you for everything, Lord, whether it's good or bad. Lord, we thank you because through it all, Lord, we know it's meant for our good. Lord, we ask that you forgive us of our sin, creating us clean hearts and renew a right spirit within us. Help us to continue to grow to be disciples that you are calling us to be, especially radical disciples. Lord, help us, Lord. We cannot make it without you. We cannot live without you. We cannot move without you, Lord. We cannot think without you, Lord. Lord, we are nothing without you, Lord. Help us, Lord. Fill us with your Holy Spirit in order that we can fulfill all the things you are calling us to do, Lord. Help us to overcome all of our shortcomings. Lord, continue to transform us into your image, Lord. Lord, we can't do this without you, Lord. Lord, we ask that you would go in the hospital room, nursing homes, sick room, wherever your people are, Lord. Touch them right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we ask that you would go behind the prison walls. Touch them right now, Lord. You know whether they're innocent or guilty, but still touch them right now. Draw them closer to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, not only go behind the prison walls, but go all over our community, state, nation, and world, and touch your people that somebody this day will surrender their lives to you and accept you as Lord and Savior and follow you, Lord. Lord, we ask that you anoint the scripture that will be read, anoint the message that will be proclaimed to your people. These and other blessings we ask in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen, amen, and amen. Okay, if you have your Bibles with you, whether it's your actual Bible, your physical Bible, your electronic Bible, or whatever Bible you have, whether it's on your smartphones, your iPads, your whatever tablets you have, or any whatever electronic devices that you have, come with me. Join me as we read Hebrews, the 4th chapter, verses 12 through 16. That's the book of Hebrews, the 4th chapter, verses 12 through 17. And I'll be reading the New Revised Standard Version. Again, it's the book of Hebrews, the 4th chapter, verses 12 through 16. And it reads, "Indeed, the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing until it divides soul from spirit, joints from marrow. It is able to judge the thoughts and intentions of the heart, and before him no creature is hidden, but are all naked and laid bare to the eyes of the one whom we must render an account. Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast to our confession, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weakness, but we have one who, in every respect, has been tested as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore approach the throne of grace with boldness, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. I will use as a theme for my message on today, deepening our connection with Jesus. Deepening our connection with Jesus. My brothers and sisters, in today's times, we are dealing with so many life's complex issues. We read all types of books to tell us how to deal with various situations that we are dealing with. Many of us turn to psychologists or psychiatrists. Many of us turn to our friends or family. Many of us turn to alcohol and drugs to help us cope with the many stresses in our lives. Many of us turn to various destructive behaviors. Many times we turn to every source except the most important source. That source is named Jesus. Many of us are trying to figure out what God is calling us to do or to be. Many of us are trying to figure out what is God's will for our lives, family, church, and much more. What we need to do is deepen our connection with Jesus. And there are 4 points that I will discuss on today. Point number 1, God's word is living and powerful. God's word is living and powerful. And when you look at verse 12 of this text, we see that God's word is constantly and actively alive. It is powerful. God's word judges our thoughts and intents of our hearts. It is the word that judges us. God's word convicts us of our sins. God's word converts sinners. God's word corrects our faults and errors. God's word sanctifies and transforms us. Openness to God's word keeps us on good terms with God because we are held accountable by God. Point number 2, nothing is hidden from God. Nothing is hidden from God. When you look at verse 13, we learn that God knows everything about us. Nothing we do is hidden from God. God sees all and he knows all. God is constantly aware of everything that is going on in the universe. Of course, the important point in this text is that God knows if we are real or not in our faith walk. God knows if we are walking the walk or just talking the talk. We can be active in our churches. We can have all the biblical knowledge that we need, but that does not mean that our faith walk lines up with our talk. So we have to make sure and realize that you can fool man, but you cannot fool God. Point number 3. Jesus is our great high priest. Jesus is our great high priest. In verse 14 and 15 of our text, we see that Jesus is our great high priest who identified with sinful humans, yet he remained without sin. Because Jesus already has ascended into heaven and entered into God's rest, we can be confident that we too will have a share in God's rest. Because Jesus established his role as high priest by becoming like us, he understands our human struggles. Jesus experienced sickness, hunger, persecution, rejection. Jesus faced the same temptation as all of us. We can look to Jesus, who not only pioneered our faith, but endured the cross, the cost of obedience to God. Unlike other priests, Jesus didn't need to offer sacrifices for his own sins. Instead, he offered himself faultless before God. He did it because he loves us so much, so all of us can have an opportunity for salvation. Point number 4. We can approach God through Jesus directly. In verse 16 of our text, we see that the gracious invitation is extended for us to draw near with confidence to the throne of grace. Our confidence is based on the knowledge that Jesus died to save us and that he lives to keep us. We are assured of a cheerful home because Jesus has told us to come. The people in the Old Testament days could not draw near to God. Only the high priest could approach God on one day of the year. We can go into God's presence at any time of the day or night and obtain mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. His mercy covers the things we should not have done. And his grace empowers us to do what we should do, but do not have the power to do so. Christ is the merciful high priest who mediates on our behalf. Because of his works, God grants mercy to us when we sin. God strengthens us when we undergo temptation or endure any type of hardship. In closing, we should look to Jesus during times of weakness or temptation because he experienced similar things that we are experiencing today. Jesus understands our situations and can help us to overcome them. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, we can overcome our shortcomings and help others overcome theirs as well. No matter what we have going on in our lives, let us deepen our connection with Jesus. Give our cares to Jesus. Intercede for others when we go to Jesus. If you're having financial challenges, take it to Jesus. If you have challenges on the job, take it to Jesus. If you have any form of cancer, take it to Jesus. If you have diabetes, take it to Jesus. If you have high blood pressure, take it to Jesus. If you have other forms of sickness, take it to Jesus. If you are struggling with drugs and alcohol, take it to Jesus. If you are struggling with a life of crime and violence, take it to Jesus. If you have an abusive or controlling spirit, take it to Jesus. If you are living in poverty, take it to Jesus. If you are struggling with sins in your life, take it to Jesus. Young people and us adults alike, if you are struggling with peer pressure, take it to Jesus. If you are having difficulties making wise decisions, take it to Jesus. If you are having difficult issues in our churches, take it to Jesus. If you are spiritually lost, take it to Jesus. If you want to be saved and be assured of salvation, take it to Jesus. Give your life to Jesus. No matter what's going on, take it to Jesus. If you are having if you are dealing with difficult children, take it to Jesus. If you are dealing with difficult neighbors, take it to Jesus. If you are dealing with difficult spouses or parents, take it to Jesus. If you are dealing with friends that turn their backs on you, take it to Jesus. If you feel like you keep stumbling, take it to Jesus. I'm here to let you know that Jesus is ready and he's able to help us to deal with whatever that have a stronghold on our lives. I'm here to let you know that Jesus took care of all of our problems on that cross. They put the nails in his hands, nails in his feet. He did it all just for us. All of our alcohol problems have been nailed to the cross. All of our sickness have been nailed to the cross. All of our burdens have been nailed to the cross. All of our disappointments have been nailed to the cross. All of our heartaches have been nailed to the cross. All of our shame for things we've done has been nailed to the cross. So no matter what you are facing, all we gotta do is commit to deepening our connection with Jesus, and everything will be all right. I'm here to let you know that all is well in my life. All is well in your life. We will overcome COVID-19 in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm here to let you know that COVID-19 will not get the victory. COVID-19 has already lost the battle because we have victory in Jesus. And because we have victory in Jesus, we can stay connected to Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen. The doors of the church is open. Is there anyone that don't know Jesus and the pardon of your sin? Today is a good day. Tomorrow is not promised. Today is a good day to deepen your connection with Jesus. There's room for you here at Evans Chapel United Methodist Church here in Belzoni, Mississippi. There's also room for you at Hell's Chapel United Methodist Church in Inverness, Mississippi, as well as Raspberry United Methodist Church in Indianola, Mississippi. But more important, there's room for you at the cross. Tomorrow is not promised. Jesus died in order for our sins to be forgiven. All you have to do is give your life to Jesus. Don't worry about what you're doing, your struggles. Because your struggles is not because of you. Your struggles is because of what Satan's trying to do to you. If you want to be delivered from Satan, give it to Jesus. Give your life to Jesus. And when you give your life to Jesus, Jesus will whip Satan left and right. The battle will be hard, but Jesus will get the victory. Today is a good day to give your life to Jesus. If you're looking for a church home, you can give me a call at 662-402-8696. And we can talk about it and we get everything set up. And so you can move forward and being established in the church home. Lord has got his arms open wide for you. Don't worry about it. Whatever what you got going on. All you got to do is take just a closer walk with Jesus. Take a closer walk with Jesus. And Lord, you will feel his power. As you contemplate this important decision, you will listen to Just a Closer Walk with Thee by Mahalia Jackson.
Lord, let it be. Lord. Jesus, keep me, Lord, if I'm on own. And I'll be sad for as long as I can walk. Please let me walk, Lord, close with thee.
Again, if you're looking for a church, or you can give me a call at 662-402-8696, and I can help you to begin this very important journey in your life. Amen, amen. I thank God for each of you on today. Don't neglect to give your tithes and offering to your local churches. If you want to send your financial blessings to Evans Chapel, please send them to Evans Chapel United Methodist Church, P.O. Box 773, Belzoni, Mississippi, 39038. Again, P.O. Box 773, Belzoni, Mississippi, 39038. Let's show love to each person because God continues to shower us with his love. Let's check on each other and pray for one another. Remember to follow social distancing and wear masks when in public and avoid large gatherings. And if you have not had an opportunity to be vaccinated, please do so. And those who have been vaccinated, fully vaccinated, the very first opportunity that you have to get your booster shot, please do so as well. Remember, we need to help each other fight against COVID-19. And I also want you to remember that God loves you, and so do I. Let's close for the benediction. Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all we ask or think, according to the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Let the church say amen, amen, and amen. be blessed, and enjoy the rest of this glorious day. Bye-bye.